Hello, doctors on Passmedicine.com. I am Dr. Hashem, a physician who's licensed to practice in Egypt and the United Kingdom. The last 6 months were very tough for me. I had to take MRCP exam last September, followed by PLAB 2 exam in November, and the MRCP part 2 this March. During this series of videos, I'm going to discuss with you my experience in each exam in a separate video. Unfortunately, I got my PLAB 2 exam cancelled 3 times because of the COVID pandemic. This was very frustrating for me, and this is why I decided that I have to take a parallel busway in addition to PLAB 2. So I booked the MRCP part 1 after my exam got cancelled. I didn't have enough time to study well, but I dealt with this exam as a bonus exam, so I didn't put too much pressure on myself. And for me, I think this was a very good thing, so to have less pressure and less stress while studying and while taking the exam. I started preparation for MRCP part 1 exam just 2 months before the exam, but the condensed study was the last 30 days before the exam. During my preparation, I used only one question bank, which was Passmedicine. The questions were not very similar to the exam, but the explanation was to the point. So I had limited time, as I told you, it was only 2 months, but I managed to answer about 30% of every chapter during the first month at a bit slower rate. Then I answered the remaining 70% of the question bank during the second month at a higher rate. During the first month, I used to get around 60 to 70% correct answers. During the second month, I used to get around 70 to 80% correct answer. I didn't have time to answer additional question banks in addition to Passmedicine. But I highly recommend answering the past papers and past test. In addition to Passmedicine, I used to use my book for first aid for use Melisty 1 for specific topics that I didn't feel like I understand every aspect of it after answering it through Passmedicine. In addition to that, I used to search for specific topics on YouTube. I found awesome videos and it was very helpful for me. I didn't have enough time after completing Passmedicine to have a second round and or answer it again, so I decided to read only the explanations without the questions, and actually this was very helpful, so I kept my mind fresh with all knowledge in short time. Internal medicine is really huge. They don't examine you on what you studied in the last 1 or 2 or 3 months. They examine you in what you studied since the first day in the medical school, so keep in mind this fact. And during the last day before the exam, please avoid studying extra hours because it will make more harm than good. Try to relax, eat and sleep well, stay with your family. This will be of more benefits for you to relax. And keep in mind also that you can take this exam multiple times. You don't have to pass it from the first time. In addition, the score is not very important in such exam. So keep relaxed, this will help you a lot to answer in the exam itself. In the exam itself, you will definitely feel like, oh my god, I'm going to fail this exam. This is a normal feeling. Deal with each question separately and keep in mind this is an MCQ exam. Even if you don't know anything about the answer, you still have chance of 20% to answer it correctly. If you can exclude 2 or 3 answers, you have more than 50% chance to answer the question correctly. Regarding the exam structure, you will get 3 hours for the first paper, which is around, which was 100 questions exactly, followed by short break, followed by second paper, which was additional 100 questions. I didn't have any problem with time management. The questions was short in relation with, for example, the USMLE or even MRCP part 2, so I didn't have a problem with time management. My advice regarding this is the break itself. Please take your time in the break to relax, drink a cup of tea or cup of coffee instead of revising any answers or questions. I found many doctors revising the questions between the 2 papers, but I think this is a huge mistake. you need your energy to be available for second paper. During the second paper, I felt a bit less concentration and the questions were a bit harder. So the second paper is 50% of the exam. Don't waste your energy and your brain cells in revising the first paper in the break. Just relax and prepare for the second paper. And keep in mind that with even about 80 questions wrong, you can still pass this exam, because most probably you need 120 questions correctly to pass this exam. So during the exam itself, try to motivate yourself after each question and to relax, because if you feel stressed, you will not be able to answer correctly. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions about MRCP part 1, please leave it in the comment section and I will try to answer all of your questions. And please subscribe to our channel so you can watch MRCP part 2 experience after you pass this exam. And good luck for you in this exam.